Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Wow, we have an incredibly tough one today. This question was sent in by Ben. When I first read Ben's question, I was like, there's no way to do this. But then I started to puzzle through it, and it turns out that there is. Ben wants to use data validation, and he wants to make sure that once an item has been selected from the list, it's no longer available to be entered anywhere else in the list. So we have basically set up a spreadsheet here, and let's say that we're going to enter values in this green area. And then I said, okay, let's come over to column E, type a list of all the possible values. So they're here in this list. And basically, once an item has been selected from the list, we don't want it to appear in the data validation anymore. So I came over to column F and created a column that says, has the value been used? Basically, this is a COUNTIF function that goes and checks to see if the value CA is in that green range. If it is, then it says, give me a -999. Otherwise, give me the largest value so far in this column +1. And basically, that forces Excel to give us the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But as soon as we choose a value, let me put Arizona, you'll see that Arizona gets a -999, and Florida now becomes 2, Illinois becomes 3, and so on down the line. So what we did then over here in column I is basically almost like a VLOOKUP. I couldn't do a VLOOKUP because the numbers would have to be to the left of the column, and so I used basically an index and match. Index and match says, hey, go find the value that's assigned to number 1 and then number 2. And you see that here Florida is the second value. It's ignoring Arizona because it has the -999. So we have this formula that works pretty well, except for we get a few NAs down at the bottom of the list. As I enter more values back in the input area, more NAs are going to float down to the bottom of the list. So in my dynamic range name, I need to have a count of all the non-NAs. So I use a array formula over here that says equal if is NA, I2 to I52, then give me a 0, otherwise give me a 1. Control shift enter to enter that, and it tells me how many values we have. Okay, we're almost there. Finally, we go to insert, name, define, and we use a trick from one of the previous podcasts where we say my list, instead of just being this unique list from I2, starts at I2, goes 0 rows down, 0 rows over. How many rows tall is it? Well, we use the result of our array formula over here. So in this case, it's going to be 49 and one column wide. Now, back in our original data set, we set up our data validation to use that name. So data validation, allow a list equal to my list. Click OK. And the way that it works now, when we go to the second value, Arizona's already been chosen, so it's not on the list. We'll choose something else. I'll choose Ohio. And basically now Ohio gets a -999, is removed from our list, and when we go to the third value, you'll see that Ohio is no longer in the list. We only have the remaining items in the list, and it works all the way down. So when Ben sent me this question, I was like, Ben, there's no way to do this. Well, it turns out there is a way. It's beyond what most people would ever consider doing, but if you desperately need a way to do this, it certainly would work. So thanks to Ben for sending in that question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.